Praise God.
Amen.
Praise God.
Amen.
Remember saying, amen. I thank God for you this morning. I thank God because He has kept you and He has brought you safe to our church this morning. I'm also good and I thank God because I'm alive today. Praise God. There are many who have wished to be where I am, but they are not there. But because I am, I just want to say thank you to God. Hallelujah. So this morning, we are going to look at the word of God from the book of Acts, chapter 17. And our topic is edifying myself for surrender. And as our pastor has said, this year we are scaling the heights to spiritual maturity. And the only way to mature is to be good students of the word. Praise God. Amen. Yes, maturity means acting sensibly. When you are mature, you act sensibly. And again, from January to April, we are talking about surrender. And surrender means to give, or it is an act whereby you allow somebody to control you totally. And you will not be able to surrender to God fully if you don't know God. I cannot surrender to somebody I don't know. I cannot surrender to somebody I don't trust. I will only surrender everything totally when I know you well and when I know that I can trust you and I can entrust you with my life. So the only way we get to know God is through the scripture. It is through being a very good student of the word. Because this word is the mind of God. The scripture, when you go through it, you get to know God better. So, I believe this year we will talk more of the word of God. Hallelujah. So, let's read from Acts chapter 17, beginning from verse 10 to 15. As soon as it was night, the believers sent Paul and Silas away to Berea. On arriving there, they went to the Jewish synagogue. Now the Berean Jews were of more noble character than those in Thessalonica, for they received the message with great eagerness and examined the scriptures every day to see if what Paul said was true. Many of them believed, as did also a number of prominent Greek women and men, and many Greek men. But when the Jews in the Thessalonica learned that Paul was preaching the word of God at Berea, some of them went there too, agitating the crowds and stirring them up. The believers immediately sent Paul to the coast, but Silas and Timothy stayed at Berea. Those who escorted Paul brought him to Athens and then left with instructions for Silas and Timothy to join him as soon as possible. And we all say, praise God. When you look at the entire chapter of 17, from the beginning, we are seeing Paul. Paul was in the synagogue and he was reasoning with them from the scriptures. So entirely, the whole of it is just talking about studying, reasoning with the scriptures. And where we are told of the Jews in Berea. I think the church in Berea. Now, when Paul was in Thessalonica, the Thessalonians created chaos by rioting against Paul until Paul moved on to Berea. And when Paul was again in Berea, the same Thessalonians also followed Paul again. I think they were very jealous because of the progress Paul was making when it came to reasoning about the scriptures. Because we are told, even when he was in Thessalonica, a large number of God-fearing Greeks and not a few prominent women believed in Paul. Praise God. So the devil is always a liar. When he sees people are getting in tune with the word of God, he rises. But we thank God because in this word, we have victory in Jesus' name. We have the power, and that power is the power we get from the word, that we've been given power and authority. So it doesn't matter. Even if they arose and Paul moved on, still the word of God was continued to be preached. Praise God. So nothing will hinder the word of God. Whether Satan likes it or not, the word of God will always be preached. Hallelujah. And even here, if you are here and you are not a believer, maybe you are a rioter, still the word will be preached. Amen. And people will listen and they will believe in the word. And you will see success in, and victory in the word of God. Praise God. Amen. So, to edify means, as I read from the English dictionary, it says, improving people's minds or character by teaching them about something. So today we want to edify ourselves. And what are we teaching? We are teaching you something from the word of God. Hallelujah. And we believe that at the end of it, your mind will be full of the word and your character will change in Jesus' name. Because once you are full of the word and your character is okay, then you can surrender totally to God. Hallelujah. Because you will have known who this God is. You will have much knowledge about him. And you will be able to trust him so that you may entrust your life totally to him. Surrender and tell God, I am withdrawing. I am surrendering my will. I'm surrendering everything about me. Please come and have control over my life. And once we've surrendered, then we will be able to mature. Because now God will take center stage in your life and he will begin to teach you slowly by slowly. Hallelujah. And you will keep on growing until you reach maturity in Jesus' name. And then you will be able to say that you are a mature Christian because you act sensibly in the things of God. Praise God. Hallelujah. Yes, we all desire to mature. We all desire to mature. Okay, we will mature. So I want to say, as we look at this text for the day, we are seeing three things about these Berean Jews. One, they were of more noble character. Two, we are told, they received the word with great eagerness. And three, they examined the scriptures to verify Paul's words. And finally, they believed in the word. Hallelujah. Amen. So even this morning, we are doing the same thing that Paul was doing. He was reasoning with them concerning the scriptures. And I want us to learn just a few things about the word of God. The Bible in Romans chapter 12 and verse 2, it says, beginning even from verse 1 and 2, that we give our lives as a living sacrifice to God. And then in verse 2 it says that we should not conform, but we should be transformed by the renewing of our mind. And what renews our mind? It is the word of God. Hallelujah. And once our minds are renewed, we will be able to know what is God's will. And once you know what God's will is concerning your life, you will do the will of God. Hallelujah. And as you do the will of God, then you will be able to grow in the things of God. You will be able to grow in the spiritual things. So this word of God is a word that has power to renew our minds. It has power to renew our minds so that we get to know what the will of God is. So I believe as Paul was reasoning with them, he was reasoning with them so that they may be able to know that this word, so that this word of God may renew their minds so that they may get to know what the will of God is. Yes, the word of God is the mind of God. The more you study this word, the more you get to know God in your life. So, as you read this word every day, as you purpose to study every day, you are purposing to get to know more God, to know more of God in Jesus' name. So I want us to encourage one another that this year, because we want to fully surrender to God and mature in him, then let us actually take time to study the word. Let us be students of the word this year. Let the word of God richly dwell in us. And then we will be able to mature in the things of God. You know, there are people who don't even know of the word, and yet they call themselves Christians. So that at times people quote scriptures and you believe in them, and who may even they are not the correct ones. Like people used to like to say that Mungu amesema, which Ukiuliza mtu kweli hiyo iko wapi iko wapi? Ati Mungu amesema, which is wrong. But when you are a very good student of the word, you will know that God says, I will bless the work of your praise God. At the time of this idea, amesema, I will bless the work of your. So God blesses. So as you read this word, you get to know that when I work, God blesses the work of my hands. Hallelujah. And when you read even this word, you get to know that at a call at the same time, anybody who is lazy should not eat. So that speaks to you that you have to work so that you eat. Sindio? Lakini siku sema ati, Mungu alisema ujisaidie ili nifanye nini? No, that is not in the word. So the more we read, the more we study, the more we are more knowledgeable of the word. And even there is a saying that says knowledge is power. That is why even in the contemporary world, people specialize in careers. You specialize so that you master everything about that area of specialization, so that you can be able to deliver well. Simio. So that is why we have doctors, but even as they are doctors, they are lines of specialization. Kuna wale wanafanyanga surgery, kuna wale sijui wanadeal na skin, kuna wamacho, because they want to master it as long as that field is concerned. Because if you have that mastery, then you will be able to deliver well in Jesus' name. And I want to say, even us as Christians, we have to really have mastery in the word of God, so that wherever we are going to be Christians who are really Christians, who can stand against any kind of temptation in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Amen. So that you will not even fear, even if storms arise, you will be able to stand and know that the one is in me is the storm comer. Because that is the word says, when the storms arose, Jesus stood and told the storms to be still. Then you will know that the one I have, the God that I have, is the God who can calm every storm in my life. Hallelujah. Amen. By what? He tells us that we are more than conquerors, that we are more than victors, that nothing in this world can separate us from the love of God. So as you study, you get to know what God wants in your life. Hallelujah. And you get to know what God has given you. You know, there are things that God has given us, but we don't know. But as we study, we get to know our rights as Christians. Hallelujah. Amen. We get to know what God has given us as his children. So, I have said that this word informs our minds. It informs our minds, and our minds are renewed. And when our minds are renewed, we get to know what the will of God is. And as we get to know what the will of God is, we do the will of God. And that, you mature. Through God's word, again, this word of God has power. It is a powerful word. It changes, it transforms. It transforms lives of people. Like here in verse 12, we are told, many of them believed, as did also a number of prominent Greek women and many Greek men. And in verse 17, chapter 17, verse 4, we are told, and not a few prominent women, even in Thessalonica. I want to tell you that this word is a powerful word. Hallelujah. And this word of God, God himself says, he is not a respecter of any person. All people before God are the same. Whether poor, whether rich, whether learned or not, all of them in the eyes of God are equal. Hallelujah. That is why I want you to take a lot of pride when you're in the house of God and cease comparing yourself with people. Just know that we are all equal in the sight of God. Hallelujah. It doesn't matter how much you own or how little you own. We are all equal as we are seated here. Because our God is a God who is not partial. He is a God of equality. Praise God. And this word of God is powerful. That is why even these prominent men, even though they had what they had to be called prominent, they were able to subject to the word of God, because it is a powerful word. Hallelujah. It carries a lot of power. When you look at John 1 verse 12, the Bible says that as many as they believed servants were there. Let there be what? And it was there. This word is a powerful word. Hallelujah. That is reason enough for you to take time and be a student of the word. Because the more you know of this word, many things will change in your life. Hallelujah. Praise God. Amen. So this word, as in Hebrews 4:12, it says, the word of God is active. And it is alive and it is active. It is sharper than a double-edged sword. It is able to penetrate and to put asunder the bone and the marrow, and even to discern the thoughts in the heart of man. Praise God. Hallelujah. Isn't it a powerful word that we ought to know so that we live this word and we see things changing day by day as we speak the word which is alive. Hallelujah. Amen. Allah, a word that speaks, when we speak this word against any mountain, mountains bow in Jesus' name. When we speak this word, when the troubles of life are there, there is calm in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. When your heart is full of anxiety and you choose to speak the word of God, there is peace. Hallelujah. That is why God was reasoning and telling these people about this word, because it carries every answer in this word. Even the answer to our nation, it is in the word of God. Hallelujah. And once we become students and master this word and start living this word, even things in this nation will change in the name of Jesus. When we begin claiming those who are once born again, those leaders who are once Sunday school children, and they've gone away from the way of God, when we begin speaking this word, they will come back in Jesus' name. Because we need them for the nation to be healed. We need Christians for the nation to be healed. Praise God. So let us go back to the word, because it carries the solutions and the answers to many nations, to many people. Let us go back and study, and study, and study, so that God may be exalted in Jesus' name. Praise God. So as I was saying, this word is powerful, it is alive, it is active, it is able to penetrate. And when Peter was addressing the crowd after Pentecost, in chapter 2 of Acts, verse 37, we are told these people, when they listened to Paul speaking, when they listened to Paul reasoning about the word, I tell you, the Bible tells me that they were cut to the heart. They were pricked and said in desperation, what shall we do? Hallelujah. Are you seeing the power of the word? It is able to penetrate. Mpaka mtu anakuwa na wasiwasi na anasema, what shall I do? Because they had no peace of mind. Mpaka they had to ask what they were to do. So this word is a powerful word. This word is a word that is alive. This word is a word that penetrates into the hearts of men and brings change in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. And this word we are told in 2 Timothy chapter 2 and verse number 16. The Bible tells us that all scripture is God-breathed and is useful for teaching. It is useful for rebuking. It is useful for correcting and training in righteousness, so that all God's people are thoroughly equipped for every good work. Praise God. So as we speak this word enables you, makes you to be thoroughly equipped. It equips you for the things of God. You cannot go and serve God if you are not fully equipped. And I always tell Christians, not unless you are fully equipped, you will not even be able to counterattack the devil. Because the devil has knowledge of this word. He knows everything about this word. And I want to tell you that you cannot, even Jesus Christ, in the times of his temptation, the only thing that gave him victory was by saying, it is written. Hallelujah. Amen. Even you, if you want success and victory in your Christian life, this word has to richly dwell in you, so that you have a word for every situation. Because I have told you that this word carries the solution to every problem of humanity. Praise God. So when you have that word in you, you are able to overcome temptation katika jina la Yesu. So I want to encourage us. It is, at times we rebuke and people think students of the world. That is why you should even buy those daily bread, you buy the diary, because there are scriptures for every day to help the lazy people. You know, we have lazy we have lazy people, senor. When it comes to reading the word, they don't. They just open the Bible on Sunday, and it is not even the Bible nowadays. They just, the phone, they access the Bible on Sunday until Sunday. So please get one for yourself to help you come out of your laziness, so that you open and see that I read. And you know, in the diary, see it in the scripture, it might be just one verse or two. It will help you and you will grow. Praise God. Amen. Because you know that at the end of it all, something will have happened in your life. Amen. Hallelujah. So the word of God, again, it is the sword of the Spirit, the sword of the Spirit. In Ephesians 6 and verse 17, the Bible says, the word is the sword of the Spirit. You know, as Christians, we are at war. As Christians, we are at war. The enemy is at war with us. And if you don't have this word, surely, which is the sword that will help you fight, what will you use? Jesus Christ knew the word. That is why he was able to overcome the devil. What do you have? What do you have? What do you have as your sword? Have the word of God. Hallelujah. So that when the enemy comes, you speak the word. And that sword is able, as we've been told in Hebrews chapter 4 verse 12, that it is like a double-edged sword. So you use that word to fight with it, and you get victory and success in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise God. Amen. Am I encouraging you? That we go back to the Bible. We go back, even Pastor Fenn in a sermon, I mean, knowledge is? So, if you have this knowledge, the mastery of the word, you are a powerful Christian. If you don't have this knowledge of this word, if you don't have the power of the word in you, then you are a very weak Christian. Yeah, Papa, when the storms, you see Ephesians that we will not be tossed to and fro by the storms, by the waves that come along. So that when you hear so-and-so is somewhere, you run there. Because you're being tossed to and fro, you don't know the word. But when you know the word, you will not keep on running up and down. You will stand and mature and say, I know the word, I know this is where I ought to be, and I believe in the word of the Lord. Praise God. Amen. So, therefore, for your own self-edification, what should you do? One, ensure that you keep the right company. Look here. The Bible is telling us that in Thessalonica, there were people who were of very bad character. And as you say, to edify means improving people's minds or characters. So your character will only improve when you keep the right company. Praise God. Amen. The Bible says in 1 Corinthians 15:33 that bad company ruins good. Ruins what? Good morals. And the Bible in Psalms chapter 1, it says, blessed is the man who does not walk, or sit in the seat of scorners, but whose delight is in the law of the. That is what the Bible says. Blessed is the man who does not walk in the counsel of the wicked, or sit in the seat of scorners. You cannot tell me you will mature. You cannot tell me this theme of ours will be realistic for you in this year if you will still keep the company that is bad. You have to come out in the name of Jesus. Praise God. Hallelujah. Because surrendering means you let go of the things that you even love most. You let go even of the friends. You get out of those toxic relationships and you choose to be where you're supposed to be. Praise God. I was telling the ladies the other day that even friends are the ones that really influence us, our peers. They really influence us. You might be among You're gifted, you have your company or whatever, you have friends along that line, you go and meet in these big hotels, at times you go for seminars in those hotels, and you know what happens, senior. Not all of them are born again, senior. So you are there and you are born again. They are having their drinks, you are having your soda. You know soda in a junk of a tumor.
No.
against God. If you are to totally surrender to God, keep the right company. The appealing for self-education is always listen to the word and also study the word. Not just listen, also study. I'm basing it on what we've read today. That these people, they listened with a lot of eagerness. And after listening, they went back to examine and verify. Is whatever I was taught true? So, you normally do that when you just listen, you write those scriptures, forever. You will never ever go back to that page. You don't even know what you wrote. You really go back and reread and examine whatever you are taught. That is what the Bible is telling us today. Let us listen. It is not only enough to listen. As you listen, go back and study. Hallelujah. Praise God. Amen. Because the more, you know the Bible says, faith comes by hearing and hearing by the word of God. You know how kuna kurudia hearing and hearing by the word of God. You need to hear until unalewa hiyo neno and then sasa unaishi hiyo neno. Praise God. And hallelujah. Ukilewa hiyo neno utaishi hiyo neno. Utatembea na hiyo neno. Because imekuja. Praise God. And then finally, what I have to say is believe in the word. Praise God. Believe in that. You know that Muslims study the word. You know Muslims know the Bible so well. But the difference between them and us is we believe and they don't. They don't believe. Praise God. So the difference between that Christian who is powerful and the Christian who is weak is the Christian who is powerful has mastered the word and has chosen to believe in the word. So that when any situation arises, she stands and says, or he stands and says, this is what the word of God says. And I speak to you, Satan. I speak to this situation by the word of God. And you see things happening in Jesus' name. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So choose to believe. Believe in the word. I want to finalize by reading John 5:39. Let us read together. 1 John 1:1 says, in the beginning, Amen. So we have good students of the word here. I'm a So in the beginning was the word. And the word was with. And the word was. Verse 14 says, the word became flesh. And man is dwelling among. We have seen his glory, the glory of the one and only Son of. So you cannot separate Jesus and the Word. Praise God. He is the Word sent from God. He came and he became flesh. He lived among us and eventually he went back to the Father. Praise God. Amen. So verse chapter 5, Jesus is telling us something there. 5:39. You study the scriptures diligently because you think that in them you possess eternal life. That is now where the Muslims go wrong. They study the word. Now wajua kwamba, hata wakijua hiyo neno. Enyewe, they study, ndio waweze to attack. Sawa tu, haina shida. But, Jesus is saying, these are the scriptures that testify about me. As you study this word, it is testifying about what? About Jesus Christ himself. Na anasema, yet you refuse to come to me to have life. How many Christians do we have who are very good church attenders? They attend church and very punctual. They don't miss, but they've never accepted the Lord Jesus Christ as their personal Savior. Being in church, studying the word, minus accepting the Lord Jesus as your personal Savior, it is futile. Praise God. Amen? Amen? And then, you know, when you read it in Acts chapter 19, the Bible says that there were the sons of Sceva. They went and tried to chase away demons in the name of Jesus that Paul was preaching. You know what happened to them? They were beaten thoroughly. Because they didn't have a belief in this Jesus. So how could they try to chase away demons and yet they don't have You know, Jesus gives meaning to the word. Praise God. He gives life to the word so that when you speak it, it is alive in the name of Jesus. So, finally, this word gives you sustainability in your salvation. When you read in 2 Peter 1, chapter 3, na kuendelea, in a time of the great promises of God, we are partakers of the divine nature of God through the great promises of God. These great promises are the ones that encourage you, are the ones that keep on telling you, be confident, have faith. You are a victor. You are a conqueror. Hallelujah. They give you that through those promises of God. Yakwamba, I will bless you. So wakati umaskini nataka kuingia, you remember what the word says. The Lord says, I will bless you. And I believe you are blessed, me God. Hallelujah. You have promised that you are with me. Yes, Lord, I might be in this thing right now, but I know that I am not alone. You are with me. The promises of God helps you to stand. Hallelujah. Amen. Even when you are in that company, you remember the word. The word says that I should not be in this company. It helps you to run away. And you are able to escape every corrupt nature of the world and be able to live a godly life. May the Lord bless you. Let's pray. Everlasting Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, Lord, I thank you. I give you glory and honor, God. Thank you, Father, for being with us today. Thank you for your word, O God, because your word is life. We thank you, Jehovah, because through this word, you've given us power to become children, your children. We have become sons and daughters in the kingdom. My Father, I want to continue praying that as we deliberate this year, to be good students of the word, I want to pray that God, you will be with us, and that, Father, you will enable us to get to understand your word and to grow in your word. We thank you, God, and we bless you. Thank you for your people. They've listened to your word. I want to pray that, Lord, you will release your power upon them so that they may go back to home and be good students of your word. I thank you and I give you glory. Thank you for your people, Jehovah. Even as they digest this word, I want to pray that, God, your will is going to take place in their lives. That, Father, they will grow towards loving you, towards seeking you, towards having a desire to live according to your will. For it is in Jesus' name I pray.
Amen. Yeah, thank you.